greatest form of control is where you think you're free when you're being fundamentally manipulated and dictated to. One form of dictatorship is being in a prison cell and you can see the bars and touch it. The other one is sitting in a prison cell but you can't see the bar, you think you're free.
What the human race is suffering from is mass hypnosis. We are being hypnotized by people like this. Newsreaders, politicians, teachers, lecturers.
We are in a country and in a world that is being run by unbelievably sick people. The chasm between what we're told is going on and what is really going on is absolutely enormous.
It's like we all know what's going down, but no one's saying shit. What happened to the home of the brave? These motherfuckers, they controlling us now, and no one's talking about how they made us try to be slaves. And everybody's just walking around, heading to clouds, who won't awaken to a dead in the grave. But then it's too late, we need to be ready to raise up. Welcome to the end of day.
Everybody is slaves, only some are aware that the government releasing poison in the air. That's the reason I collect so many guns in my lair. I ain't never caught slipping, never underprepared. Yeah, they shade sign on me, they just spring it proudly. George Bush, the grandson of Aleister Crowley. They want you to believe the lie that the enemy's Saudi. The enemy ain't Saudi, the enemy around me. It's fluoride in the water, but nobody know that. It's also a prominent ingredient in Prozac.
For real?
How could any government bestow that upon people who believe in political throwback? That's not all that I'm here to present you. I know about the Black Pope in Solomon's temple.
Yeah.
About the Vatican assassins and how they will get you. And how they clone Barack Hussein Obama in a test tube.
It's like we all know what's going down, but no one's saying shit. What happened to the home of the brave? These motherfuckers, they controlling us now, and no one's talking about how they made us try to be slaves. And everybody's just walking around, heading to clouds, who won't awaken to a dead in the grave. But then it's too late, we need to be ready to raise up. Welcome to the end.
Whoever built the pyramids had knowledge of electrical power. And you know that that's the information that they suppress and devour. Who you think the motherfuckers that crashed in the tower? Who you think that made it turn into ash in an hour? The same ones that invaded Jerome. The ones that never told you about the skeletons on the moon. Yeah, the ones that poison all the food you consume. The ones that never told you about the Mount Vesuvius tombs. The bird flu is a lie, the swan flu is a lie. Why would that even come as a surprise? Yeah, the polio vaccine made you die. It caused cancer and it cost a lot of people their lives. Do y'all know about Bohemian Grove? How the world leaders sacrificing children in robes? Lucifer is God in the public school system. I suggest you open up your ears and you listen.
It's like we all know what's going down, but no one's saying shit. What happened to the home of the brave? These motherfuckers, they controlling us now, and no one's talking about how they made us try to be slaves. And everybody's just walking around, heading to clouds, who won't awaken to a dead in the grave. But then it's too late, we need to be ready to raise up. Welcome to the end of day.
The greatest hypnotist on planet Earth is a oblong box in the corner of the room. It is constantly telling us what to believe is real.
If you can persuade them that what they see with their eyes is what there is to see, you got them. Because they'll laugh in the face of an explanation that portrays the bigger picture of what's happening. And they have.
Either pay for it or put it back.
The master signifier beneath the chain of knowledge. We learn to see dictatorship in democracy. There is, of course, a naive aspect in this staging, reminding us of the not so well-known fact that some friends told me this. In the 1960s, the leadership of the Communist Party of the United States, in order to account for its failure to mobilize workers, seriously entertained the idea that the US population is already controlled by some secretly distributed drugs in air, in water supply, and so on. But I think we do not need aliens or secret drugs or gases or whatever. The form of ideology does the work without them. It is because of this form that the depicted scene nonetheless stages our truth. Look at the front page of our daily newspapers. Every title, even and especially when it pretends just to inform us, contains an implicit injunction. So when you are asked to choose between liberal democracy and fundamentalism, it is not only that one term is obviously preferred. What is more important, the true injunction is to see this as the true choice, to ignore third options. So again, naive as it may seem, the film's staging of ideology is nonetheless more complex than it may appear. Once you put the glasses on and see it, it no longer determines you, which means that before you see it through the glasses, you also saw it, but you were not aware of it. I use here a joke that I'm almost ashamed to tell the story again. I use it so often, but nonetheless, I will do it briefly. You know, my joke with Donald Rumsfeld ontology, known knowns, unknown knowns, and so on. Literally, through these glasses, you see the unknown knowns, things that you don't know that you know, but nonetheless, you read them, they determine you. There is a further scene which makes, sorry, feature which makes this scene of putting on the glasses contemporary. In it, the ideological injunction is hidden so that it can only be directly seen through the glasses. Such a relationship between visible and invisible is predominant in our so-called postmodern non-authoritarian consumerist societies, in which we subjects are no longer addressed on behalf of some big ideological identity, but we are simply addressed as subjects of pleasure. Today's ideology doesn't tell us sacrifice yourself for your country. The dominant message is realize yourself, enjoy life, make the best of it, and so on and so on. The master's injunction is hidden. But this is not how traditional ideology works. In the traditional, more traditional ideology, it is almost an inverse relationship. The explicit text addresses us as followers of some big cause, while the implicit message delivered between the lines concerns the obscene surplus enjoyment with which we are bribed if we subject ourselves to the cause. Like, for example, become a good fascist. Let's imagine a fascist poster. Do your duty towards your country, defend it against Jewish communist plot, become a fascist. Then you put on the same glasses and you can read. Okay, and you can read. And you can steal from the Jews, beat and lynch them, and so on and so on. Become a good Catholic priest, serve God. You put on the glasses, you can read, and you can play with the young boy as a dessert for it. Or get properly married, you put on the glasses, and an occasional discreet affair is tolerated. Now let's go someplace quiet so we can talk this over. The lesson is that our liberation from ideology is not a spontaneous act, an act of discovering our true self. Just think how it totally turns around the usual New Age idea of critique of ideology, which would be in everyday life we have ideological glasses. Learn to put down, take off the glasses and see with your own eyes reality the way it is. No, unfortunately, it doesn't work like this. Liberation hurts. You have to be forced to put your glasses on.
Come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubblegum. Oh, shit.